Drawing any 3D object is actually really easy, and it's a really cool trick. Well, let me show you how it's actually done without hiding the parts that most people do when they show you this on YouTube. First, you gotta find a good image. Anything will work. It helps if it's smaller and it already looks 3D. You can draw an image or you can just go out and find one. Next, you need to use a vector arts program. I like to use CorelDRAW, but Illustrator, even you can do this in Photoshop if you really want to. All I do is I pull it into my vectors graphics program, then I change it into a vector graphics because it makes it easier in this program. What is super cool about CorelDRAW, and I guarantee you this is the program that everyone is using that does these professionally, is that it enables you to change perspective of an image very, very easily, and that's what I'm doing now. I just outline it into a shape that looks like a piece of paper laying down. Then I change the perspective and stretch it out so that that shape looks like an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. Then all I have to do is export it as a picture. Once I have it exported, I just pull up my trusty tablet, pull it into my tablet, and I use a cool program called Android Lightbox, which is really cool because it allows me to trace on top of any tablet. I gotta turn my light off so I can actually see what I'm doing. Next, all I'm doing is I'm tracing my image. Once again, definitely one of the parts that everybody's been leaving out when they make these videos, but I guarantee you this is what they're doing. The reason they have to trace it is because to get the perspective correct is actually very, very challenging. You can do it manually and there are tricks, but it takes a lot of more work. So this is definitely what most people are doing, and the pros are doing it this way because it gives them a much better finished product. Now that I have my basic dimensions, I'm going to add a little bit of shading underneath, then I'm going to flesh out my lines and make sure that they're nice and dark. Now I'm just going to add shading to my object. Once again, I used a cube because it is a great object to illustrate how this works, but any object will work as long as you get the shading correct. Remember, use the shading from your original picture. Don't try to shade it out of perspective, so just use whatever the shading looked like on the original. Next, all I'm doing is just cleaning up my lines, darkening, and finishing the drawing. Trust me, the more time you spend here, the better your finished product will look, because this is the difference between an amateurish looking drawing and a very professional looking drawing. It makes a huge difference once you actually pull this thing and try to look at it in perspective. So take your time here. This is really simple. All you need to do is cut the top half of the paper off away from your image. This lends a great visual effect in the final product. I also cut off the edges at an angle so it looks like the piece of paper is going off into the distance. Don't overthink this, but try to get it right in the same size on both sides. Now, it's just all about the angle. Here's the part that most people will definitely never tell you. This trick is really cool on video and on a regular camera, but in real life, because you have two eyes, your brain figures out that this is not really the correct perspective. So it looks really cool on video, but in person it looks a little dicey because your brain figures out that it's out of perspective. But using one lens like a video camera or my trusty camera, it can't tell the difference, and you can place it exactly where you need to get the perfect angle. This is definitely a cool trick, and I don't mean to take away anything from the artists that are out there doing it, because it does take a lot of time, and it does look really cool, and the drawing has to be very, very good. Well, that's pretty much it. If you got any questions, you know where to track me down on my YouTube channel now, CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.